a senior in computer engineering here at the University of Illinois, and I'm enrolled in Professor Hawkins' electric violin class. What you see here is a 3D printed electric violin. The model is called the Mina. It's made by Jim Axelson, and the files are available online through Thingiverse and other places. I printed and assembled this violin at the EC Open Lab here on campus. This violin is designed with the outline of an acoustic violin, and it accepts a standard chin rest and shoulder rest. As such, it is very comfortable to hold and play. The cost of the violin comes to maybe a few hundred dollars in total. In fact, the cost of the strings, tuners, and screws is more than the cost of the plastic. The bridge on this violin is also 3D printed using my own design. I'm of the opinion that good electric violin pickups are expensive and hard to find, so I tried making my own. The bridge has four piezo sensors, one per string, inserted into the plastic bridge body. The design of the bridge was loosely based on the Barbera bridge. The first bridge that I made actually used the same two-piece construction, but I found out that that made the bridge not stiff enough, and that introduced a lot of wolf tones into the sound. So the current iteration is made of one piece of plastic with slots cut out to try and isolate the strings from each other. The shape of the bridge has to be a balance between acoustic properties and playability, as it is with traditional bridges. There are some advantages to 3D printing the bridge. First, since each bridge costs pennies worth of plastic to fabricate, it's very cheap to make. Also, since the entire design process is done on a computer, it is very easy to make small adjustments to the shape of the bridge. Then with 3D printing, it's easy to build the bridge with very little effort on my part. I'm not a luthier, but I can run a 3D printer. The current design iteration has some acoustic problems that are still to be solved. One of the high notes on the E string causes distortion in the pickup sensors. So I'll be trying some new sensors and new designs to try and solve the problems.